Some of you had requested a compilation of financial and economic terms. So here it is. If you want some other words that are not covered here, please mention them in the comments section, and we will make a separate list for them. For this video, we'll take a reference from an article on NDTV Profit, headlined as Sensex closes 23 points higher, Nifty settles at 10876, 10 things to know. You can find the original article at the below mentioned link. So with that disclaimer out, let's get on with our video. The idea is to understand what is the meaning of the word as well as where exactly are they used. Top gainers on the 50 Scrip Index Nifty were Yes Bank, Wipro, Cipla, Dr. Reddy's and Tech Mahindra. Here we look at Nifty and 50 Scrip Index. Nifty is the name given to the benchmark index for National Stock Exchange or NSE. Lots of companies are listed on it, but not necessarily part of the benchmark index, which is made up of top 50 companies, which gives it its other name, Nifty 50. These top 50 companies are also known as blue chip companies. And 50 Scrip Index refers to the 50 stock, and each stock is given a script or a short name, hence the name 50 Scrip Index. Banking stocks witness selling pressure on NSE. In contrast, IT, realty, and healthcare stocks outperform the benchmark index. Here we'll be looking at the word benchmark index, which refers to either BSE's index, better known as Sensex, or be it NSE's index, known as the Nifty. Thus, any index of any stock exchange can be called benchmark index when it is used for comparison, whether be it in our own or for some other countries like Dow Jones or Nasdaq from US. So what is compared here? Performance is compared, be it for a stock or a mutual fund. So if index closed at 2.5% higher and stock X closed 6.25% higher, it essentially means the stock has outperformed the index on which it is either listed or is being compared to. 13 out of 30 stocks close in the green. Top gainers in the 30 share Sensex pack were Yes Bank, Wipro, Kotak Bank, Mahindra & Mahindra, Sun Pharma and Maruti. Sensex is an index of BSE or Bombay Stock Exchange and is made up of top 30 companies. Here the statement closed in the green means it closed at a higher price value compared to its previous one, and vice versa, when it closes below its last value, we can say closed in the red. Closed means at the end of the trading day. Share of non-banking financial companies gained after RBI relaxed rules to sell or securitize their loan books in a bid to ease persistent stress in the sector. Shares of Dewan Housing Finance Corporation Limited closed 5.71% higher on BSE, while those of Bajaj Finance Limited closed at 0.69% higher on the index. To securitize means to convert an asset, especially a loan, into a marketable securities, typically for the purpose of raising cash by selling them to other investors. This can include loans which are backed by an asset, like car loans, housing loans, etc. And future cash flows like ticket sales, credit card payments, car rentals, or any other form of future receivables can also be securitized. Thus, these entities can raise more funds through the securitization route, which will provide them with additional liquidity today instead of waiting for the future payments, thereby easing cash crunch. According to R.K. Gupta, Managing Director, Taurus Asset Management, the decline in international crude oil prices and strengthening of rupee were the positives on Friday. Investors are also eyeing outcome of G20 meet over the weekend, he said. Here we'll be looking at the asset management. It may apply to both, to tangible assets like physical objects such as buildings or equipment, and to intangible assets such as human capital, intellectual property, goodwill, or financial assets. Asset management is a systematic process of developing, operating, maintaining, upgrading, and disposing of assets in the most cost-effective manner, including all costs, risk, and performance attributes. Attributes means factors. The term is commonly used in the financial sector to describe people and companies who manage investments on behalf of others. Brent was down 55 cents at 55.96 a barrel by 1015 GMT or 3:45 p.m. IST, while U.S. crude was down 75 cents at $50.70. Brent crude is a major trading classification of sweet and light crude oil that serves as a major benchmark price for purchase of oil worldwide. The grade is described as light because of its relatively low density and sweet because of its low sulfur content. Brent crude is extracted from the North Sea. The word, when used as Brent blend, it means a combination of crude oil from 15 different oil fields in the North Sea area and is the major benchmark for other crude oils, especially in Europe or Africa. Crude oil refers to the oil found in the natural state, that is, before any processing or refining. It is formed from the remains of plants and animals. That is why it is called fossil fuel. Most of the compounds consist of molecules made up of hydrogen and carbon atoms, hence also known by the name hydrocarbons, and is refined by fractional distillation process, which takes use of differential boiling points. Speaking of some other major types, there is WTI and OPEC basket. WTI refers to the West Tax Intermediate, or WTI. Is an extremely high quality crude oil, greatly valued as more and better gasoline or petroleum, can be refined from a single barrel compared to most other types of oil. OPEC Reference Basket, or ORB, is a weighted average of prices of petroleum blends produced by OPEC members. Since January 1, 2017, the OPEC Reference Basket consists of a weighted average of the following 13 crude oils from different countries. Earlier, there were only 7. The rupee rose for a fourth straight day, up 13 paise. Here, we will be looking at intraday and greenback. The term intraday refers to trading duration that takes place within a day. Therefore, an intraday refers to the trading done, that is buying and selling, within one single day. And greenback is used as a slang for US dollars due to its green color. Trading sentiment was mixed ahead of the two-day G20 summit in Argentina. Here, we'll be looking at trading sentiment. Refers to the feeling or attitude of investors or speculators being either bearish or bullish. The word bearish means expecting the prices to go down, and bullish means expecting the prices to go up. Also referred as market sentiment or investor sentiment. They are an important force shaping the market. For example, a company might have a good order bookings, which means more money for the company and better performance. Better performance plus new money is equal to higher share price due to good business. But still, investors start selling its share in anticipation of something bad. That is, sentiments turning negative. Typically happens during a phase of bad publicity, lawsuits, scandals, change of policies, etc. Investors also turned cautious ahead of the gross domestic product or GDP data. Here we'll be looking at GDP or gross domestic product. GDP is one of the measure of national income for a country. It can be measured by income method, expenditure method, and by the product or value added method. Calculating GDP takes into account the value of goods and services produced in a country in a span of 1 year. Thus, national income can be expressed in gross, that is GDP or GNP, or can be expressed as net, NDP and NNP. GDP stands for gross domestic product, GNP stands for gross national product, and NDP stands for net domestic product, NNP stands for net national product. On Thursday, on a net basis, foreign portfolio investors bought shares worth ₹823.47 crores, while domestic institutional investors were net buyers to the tune of ₹973.31 crores. Here we'll be looking at portfolio investors and domestic institutional investors. A portfolio investment is a grouping of assets such as stocks, bond, and cash equivalents. Portfolio investments are held either directly by an investor or managed by financial professionals, that is the institutions. And when the word foreign is used as a prefix before them, it means the origin of money is from a foreign land. Whereas DII, institutional investors which undertake investment in securities and other financial assets of the country that they are based in, that is domestic. Examples are banks, insurance companies, mutual funds investing within India. Institutional investors means an organization that invest on behalf of its members. Examples can be endowment funds, commercial banks, mutual funds, hedge funds, pension funds, and insurance companies. Next, we'll be looking at on a net basis. There are two ways of expressing a transaction, either by means of gross or by net. Gross refers to any quantity or amount or value from which necessary deductions have not been made, whereas net refers to any quantity or amount or value from which necessary deductions have been made. For example, you buy a 10 kg apple. Now it came with a box. Now, if the weight of box is 0.5 kg and actual weight of apples is 9.5 kg, then you can say the gross weight was 10 kg because the net weight of the box is 0.5 kg and net weight of the apples is 9.5 kg. Thank you and see you in the next one.